previous video, we talked about the proper way to mount a sample on a slide. Using that method, allowing the mounting medium to flow under the cover glass, reduces the possibility of introducing air bubbles into the sample. But what if you do have air bubbles in your sample? What do they look like underneath the microscope? Are there advantages of having air bubbles in your sample? Do they help you to evaluate the type of sample you have? Let's take a closer look. Sometimes we observe very tiny spheres which show a black cross between cross polars. They are most likely air bubbles. Air bubbles in any transparent solid or liquid matrix show a black cross between cross polars. The basis for this is simply light scattered by the very high refractive index difference at the interface between air and the medium. The black cross is due to the position of the polars. The intensity of the color borders on the air bubbles seems to be related to the degree of strained freeness of the microscope optics. Sometimes a sample will produce air bubbles as a result of being heated. This typically happens with samples that have high water content. Most hydrates will decompose when heated to about 100 degrees Celsius. The sample boils in their own water of crystallization. The quality can be helpful when identifying unknown white powders. Samples such as ammonium nitrate, alum, and plaster of Paris will actually begin to boil when prepared in melt. Air bubbles in your preps aren't all bad. Since they are so high in contrast, they can help a beginning microscopist focus on the proper plane of the sample.